Mark chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 22 to 25. Mark 8, 22 to 25. And while you are doing that, I forgot, you need to give a real big round of applause to the choir. Even if I'm the one saying so, it is still true. You are fantastic. You are a fantastic choir. Very, very good choir. Let's give the Lord another big round of applause for them. Mark chapter 8 from verse 22 to 25, and he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him, and besought him to touch him. And he took the blind man by the hand, and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes, and put his hands upon him, he asked him if he saw aught. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. After that, he put his hands again upon his eyes and made him look up. And he was restored and saw every man clearly. I want to talk to you for a few minutes because I have a plane to catch. On the second touch, somebody's going to get a second touch today. They brought a man to the Lord Jesus Christ. He was blind. And Jesus took him by the hand. I wish I have a long time, I would have showing you the implications of all this one by one. Jesus took him by the hand. Oh, how I pray that today Jesus will just come to you and take you by the hand. And then he led him aside, away from the crowd. You see, there are some miracles you get that are for you alone. When God wants to do something extraordinary for you, it takes you aside. When you read 2 Kings chapter 4, from verse 1 to 7, 2 Kings 4, 1 to 7, a man of God told the widow of Zarephath, he said, the miracle you're about to get, it's for you and you alone. Shut the door. Keep outsiders away. There are some miracles you don't want neighbor to see until it is completed. Because they could interfere. And there are some miracles that are just for you and you alone. That special miracle that God will say, hey, my son, my daughter, this is for you and you alone. Receive it this morning. He took him aside and he did something very unusual. He spit on his eyes. I'm blind, and you are spitting on my eyes. Well, what do you mean? When God wants to perform a miracle, don't limit him. Don't tell him the method he should use. You remember the story of Naaman very well. Naaman, you are the leper. You came to a man of God to help you. A man of God said, you should go and wash for 7 times in River Jordan. And he got angry. He said, what's wrong with him? There are cleaner rivers in my nation. Why don't I wash in them and be clean? Hey, go. He said, I thought he would come out, strike his hand on the leprosy, and then call on his God. You are teaching God how to do things. Is there anybody here today who will say, whatever method you want to use, God, just give me my miracle? After he spat on his eyes, he then touched him. Gave him the first touch. Just one touch is enough to solve any problem. One touch from the Most High God can take care of every problem. One of these days, if God will allow us to come back, we'll talk about how a single touch is enough. Because when you take somebody like the leper in Matthew chapter 8, from verse 1 to 3, Matthew 8, 1 to 3, he was a leper. And because he was a leper, he's automatically a poor man. Because he was a leper, he was banished from the gathering of multitudes, etc., etc. But just one touch changed everything. I pray for someone here today. The Almighty God will touch you. And then he said to him, now I've touched you. Can you see anything? Oh, he said, I can see men walking like trees. That tells you this man had been able to see before. He knew trees. And he could, you know, when men are around. But then something went wrong. And now he couldn't differentiate between trees or men until that touch came. But the section I want to discuss for the little time I have is that Jesus gave him a second touch. I believe very, very firmly that all of us who came here on Friday, we got a touch from God. I know that God did something last Friday for us for the next year or two
that some of us
will still be reaping the fruits. But then occasionally, God needs to touch you a second time. Amen. That's the purpose of this meeting. Amen. God wants to perfect whatever he had done in your life. Amen. And in my life too. glory be to God. Somebody is going to get a second touch this morning. Now, when we talk about a second touch, I will just give you two or three examples, and then we will pray. The first touch is good, but the second touch is better. Let's take the example of Israel. In Exodus chapter 12, from verse 30 to 36, Exodus 12, 30 to 36, when Israel got the first touch, their problem of 430 years came to an end immediately. When they got that first touch, the Pharaoh who had been holding them captive, who had said, who is God? I don't know him and I won't let Israel go, came begging, saying, please go, go quickly and bless me also. Single touch. And your number one enemy will come begging. Yes. One single touch. And all the salaries they have owed the generations of Israel for more than 430 years, they paid in one day. They were so anxious for them to leave. Whatever they asked for, they gave them. I have good news for someone. Whatever the devil has stolen from you must be restored. But then by the time you go out to Exodus chapter 14, what do we see? Suddenly the enemies gather themselves together and say, let's pursue them. We'll catch up with them and bring them back into bondage. We will bring them back, take all the money they have taken from us, take everything, reduce them to square one. Then God gave them a second touch. The Red Sea opened. The children of Israel passed through on dry ground. The enemy followed. The sea closed on them. And something happened that Moses prophesied. He said, the enemies we have seen before, you will never see them again. A second touch seals your victory. Amen. A second touch means if you have been sick and you were healed on Friday, you will never be sick again. My children have asked me, if you are never sick again, how are you going to die? You don't have to be sick to die. And may I decree to somebody here today, for the rest of your life, you will know no sickness. A second touch will make sure that everything you have taken back from Satan, Satan will not be able to steal it again. A second touch can do a lot of things. I'll give you another example. Take Daniel chapter 3. You can read the whole story. The true Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the fiery furnace. And God gave them a touch. How? Because the Son of God himself was there in the fire waiting for them. So they made contact with him, and suddenly the fire that was supposed to kill them became like an air-conditioned room. The ropes binding them was completely destroyed. The people who threw them in were killed just in one touch. A single touch can put an end to your yokes. A single touch can humiliate your enemy. Even Pharaoh, Nebuchadnezzar, got up and said, I thought we threw three men in, now I can see four. Hey, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, come out. And they came out of the fiery furnace. That was the first touch. And that was beautiful. But if you read the story to the end, you will see that they got a second touch. Because the king now said, I promote you. They were ordinary slaves when they threw them in. That will be with the second touch. You can read the study your Bible very well. With the second touch, nobody ever bothered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego again. I have good news for somebody here today. The witches and wizards the forces of darkness in every part of your life. Not only have they been silenced on Friday, today I decree to you they will never come near you again.
Hi, precious beloved. It is evident when God blesses a man. The blessings of the Lord coming upon your life, it is paramount and it is of great necessity that your life will not be hidden like a city set on the hill. It can never be hidden when the blessing of the Lord comes upon it. The Lord's blessing resting upon your life even today is a sign that the hand of the Lord is upon your life. The Lord's blessing coming upon your life today is a manifestation of His faithfulness. And on this platform, we trust that the Lord brings His mighty healing power upon that terminal disease. Diseases are disappearing, even as the power of the Lord flows from the mouth of God's servant, our Father and the Lord, Pastor Iya Deboye. Healing is coming your way. Testimonies are coming your way. Salvation is coming your way. Breakthrough in every aspect, financially, academically, maritally, in all around, business-wise, ministerial-wise, breakthrough is coming your way. And in every sphere of influence, every way that you know, the blessing and the life of God will be made manifest upon your life. Don't give up on God, because God is not yet done with you. He remains the Alpha and the Omega. He remains the beginning and the end. Testimonies of the doings and the wonders of the Lord abounds, where God have healed so many, where God have blessed so many, where many have been saved by the ministry of our Father and the Lord in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And also for you to also be a partaker of this stream of blessing, a partaker of this very gospel. You can do so by sharing these videos to your loved ones. Subscribe to our YouTube channel also, and also ensure that every member of your family, everyone connected to your life, gets blessed, get lifted, are also partakers of the doing of the Lord. It is time indeed for God to bless your life. It is time indeed for God to manifest Himself mighty in your life. Believe Him. And if you've not given your life to Jesus Christ, it is the first step for you to take. Give your life to Jesus Christ and see to it that every other thing is being added to your life. Thank you, and God bless you. See you in our next video.